first of all, we have already checked out there is no intrauterine pregnancy or miscarriage. We see a part of the uterus. We see here the external large vessels, typically it's the womb. Then we have the ovary, sometimes it appears. And then next to the ovary, we have this mass. It's echogenic. It looks somehow like myometrium from comparable echogenicity. And herein you see it's not only a mass, there is also a cystic part and might be there's some structure. So might be that this is already the embryo. Look for the adnexal mass in the ovarian fossa. Look for the morphologic type. It's not only a blob, this is a big sign. And make sure that it's not into the ovary. It has to be next to the ovary. Case number two. This is a heavy picture. You see the ovary, you see fluid, you see the ectopic, and since you don't know how I move the probe, it's sometimes really difficult to say, are we going up, are we going down, left, right? If you have it in your own hands, steer the probe consciously. This is so important. We have the ovary and the luteal body here in the ovary. It's filled with blood. Physiologically, that's how it should be, but it's not the ectopic because it belongs to the ovary. And the ectopic pregnancy in this case was really a very small element. It's here in this area, here you have to wait for it, and finally it's a ring structure. A big sand, very short. Yeah, this one it was, and the rest is ovary. It was very small, 50 millimeters. What we found during surgery in the next 24 hours, and you see the uterus, you see both white ovaries hanging low, then you have the left tube, here coming the right tube, and this is filled with blood. This makes us this blob sign, and you see the blood is already dipping out from the femoral end. We put this into a bag, we removed the tube, it was a salpingectomy. Case number three, very young pregnancy, 6 weeks plus 1 day. The lady suffered from bleedings, and the HCG, the pregnancy hormone, was on a low level. Typically, with this date and this amount of pregnancy hormone, this is typically a situation where you have time and you can wait. But then, you see these pictures and they're extremely impressive. This here around, you see the more or less dark area with some white spots. This is fluid. Honestly, in ultrasound, we just talk about fluid. And in surgery, for sure, this will be blood. So this is a bloody situs, and everything here you see in this dark, these dark elements, which is plastically, let's say, maybe compressed. This is fluid, but in surgery, it will be for sure blood. You see here the ovary in between the tube. Beautiful, the femoral ends. Have you seen how they are floating? Beautifully to be seen. And if you come up, the ectopic pregnancy is here in the tube as a such called bagel sign. So the uterus, the ovary, and now moving down, let you see the tube filled with blood called the hematosalpings containing a bagel sign, the ectopic pregnancy. Case number four, the last one we had, just to show you the difference between the morphologic type we have to look for and fluid. What does this picture tell us? We have here a bowl-like structure, obviously filled with a mass. We have here something looks like banana going around and lots of intestine. Head side, foot side, ventral, dorsal. You judge this side just like in a standing patient, dead by looking this direction. You were able to check the uterus, it's empty. You have seen the left ovary. On the right side, this is the finding. And this was judged as the ectopic pregnancy. How it looks during surgery. It's exactly the same picture. You have to turn it 90 degrees because here, during laparoscopy, we have a look downside to the small pelvis. In the middle of the uterus, then this huge big element, this one, this is just a yellow body with lots of blood filled. It's in the ovary, that's why you have this white spot. And this banana that runs over this ovary ovarian cyst is the ectopic pregnancy. I mean, this is the hematosalpings, which is represented by this part of the annex, the mass itself containing the ectopic pregnancy. I can't tell you where it is, if it's just a blob sign or already a bagel sign, but you see that. It's a really huge differential diagnosis, a huge confounder. This is not the ectopic. Typically, a yellow body which has contains blood may look like this, and the ectopic pregnancy you have outside of this ovarian nest. That's why the criteria, it has to be next to the ovary. Where is the ovary? This question is so important. What's not to do? Don't hurry. Take your time. Don't rush. You can miss easily an ectopic pregnancy, wherever it is, and it's in 10%, not in the tube. That's the easiest access you can have. But if it's outside, it might be a real problem. And don't push too much. Yes, in the literature, you find some cases where an ectopic pregnancy underwent rupture during the ultrasound scans. So, yes, it depends. Some ectopics are ready to undergo rupture by themselves, and probably you just give the last push. But you should then see the free fluid and judge the blood that's in the belly and come to the right decision how to proceed.